Hello, La. Oh my gosh, that writing is so bad. Jeez. DLC. I do like how they twitch around after you kill them. It's a nice touch. Okay. Jeez Louise! That one caught me off guard. Oh, stretchy arm. Hey, why be productive when you could just watch some dickhead play Resident Evil 7 and get spooked? Yeah. Okay, that's interesting. It's confirmed to be 16 years after RE, whatever it's called. Remake. Dumb of me. Alright, let's see. Yeah. Oh yeah, I remember seeing that quick post you made about it being rainy and dark, especially after coming back from the beach. I bet that was a fun time. Goodness me. Yeah. To be honest. Yeah. You know, appreciate people watching as always. I'm glad I can bring some entertainment to people. As well as, you know, spooping myself or something. Yeah, you should be forewarned, but I'm pretty far in the game. So, just be aware of that if you don't want to get spoiled. I mean, it might be a bit too late already, but I don't really think it's that big of a well, I suppose you could argue that it is, I guess, but personally I think it's It's somewhat signposted. Oh. Okay. Shit, no, I was gonna pull some shit like that. Okay, good. If you're not worried about spoilers, personally, I'd highly suggest you get the game. It's fantastic. Like, no thanks. I'm good. Well, yeah. But no, it's a pretty great game. So far, I've really loved my time with it. Alright. Oh. Oh, okay. Yeah, cold and stormy. Here it's just cold and wintry, so, you know, I feel some of your pain. Not all of it, but I feel some of it. Yeah. So far, I've, really enjoyed this game. But yeah, glad you could join us. It's always nice to have more people in the, chat. We've had a pretty good variety, too. Oh, that's sad. Well, fair enough, then, I guess. You know, you gotta do what you gotta do. If you are... Okay. Okay, there we go. Yeah. Let's see. If you are interested... Sorry, I'm trying to figure out some technical difficulties. Oh. Okay. Okay. Yeah, it's definitely a cool game. If you ever do decide to get it, it comes highly recommended for me, at least. Let's see what the puzzle is. Trying to figure out. What the deal here is. Yeah. Yeah, keep your eyes out for a Steam sale, is what I'd say. It's definitely. Definitely a game I would say is worth your time. Okay. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm not getting the puzzle here. You're not giving me much to work off of. Okay, let's just see. This is exciting content, guys. You can just fucking watch me adjust puzzles. Okay. Goodness me. Hello, whoever that person is. Gaze. Well, I'm assuming Law knows you. I don't. I apologize. Welcome. Glad you could join us. We're just having puzzle hour, where I blindly try to solve a puzzle that I have no solution for. Goodness me. I don't understand. Like, okay, hold on. Let's just look around. Is there a fucking note? No? Yeah, I did try turning them normally, so you got this one, that one, right? Huh. That's odd. I could have sworn I put that one on the right. Okay. That's so mean. That fucking painting just... It looks slightly wrong to me in that position. Like, I thought I had to move it over there. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Well, I've got plenty of corrosive. You know, it's... Oh, jeez. Yeah, okay, that was just me being dumb, I guess. Looking at that painting slightly wrong. Oh, that's a molded. Basically, they're what happens when a bunch of horrible nightmare fungus and a human corpse love each other very much. That's what happens. Monsters stay dead, yeah. Well... Those ones do. At least. The, certain other enemies don't stay dead. Okay, cool. So we're gonna save now, because I know this is the most riveting part of every Resident Evil game. Me saving a ton. Like, you're gonna notice as this game goes on, I save a ton. It's kind of an obsession of mine. Yeah. But yeah, I definitely recommend Resident Evil 7 if you can get it on a Steam sale or something. It's a phenomenally well-made, well-thought-out game. It's kind of crazy, you know? It's like, I'm not going to say, I don't want to be smirched. Where am I? What floor are we on? Okay, we're on the second floor. Let's go up to the fourth, third floor and take care of that. Yeah, it's definitely old school RE. Like, you know, I understand people's concerns with it going, look kind of funny. With it going to first person, and I'm not gonna lie and say I don't get the concern there, but personally, it feels more like remake than a decent amount of RE games have to me. In the past few years. of the things I hate about surround sound. Yeah. Because I can hear them moving around in the walls. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I don't think it's one-to-one, obviously. Like, in my opinion, it is, of course, you know, it's not one-to-one, but it harkens a lot more back to actually being a horror game, to me personally. Like, I've been legitimately more scared in this game than I have, by anything like RE5 or even RE4, which, I mean, I won't say RE4 doesn't deserve credit, but personally I prefer games like this to it, and Remake to it as well. You know, it's just it's a matter of personal preference, though. It totally is. Yeah, I think phrasing it as, like, being a spiritual successor in some ways is kind of the correct tone. In some ways it is just kind of Resident Evil, though. Just depends on your perspective, I think. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, 4 was never really super scary to me. There was the sound of that. Yeah, sorry, I forgot that I had the bombs. They're a non-factor for 90% of the game, so of course when I finally got them, you know, I didn't really think about it. Okay. More corrosive. Ooh, more bombs. Wait, what's this? Good. Ammo around the corner. Hold on, let's go find that. Since I clearly missed it. Yes. Oh, okay, that was the bomb. Not necessarily what I consider ammunition, but it depends on your perspective, I guess. It's fine, I picked up the bomb. We're good. Oh, I can't open that door. Okay. Alright, whatever. Oh, I actually need a lockpick or something. Okay, yeah. But yeah, definitely. I'd say it it feels more... It's more horror feeling, you know? Whereas something like... something like... What's it called? RE4, even. Especially the later REs. We don't need to get into that whole mess, but point is, you know, it's a horror game, you know, unlike something like those games, it is definitely a horror focused game, more horror focused than RA1, you know, I can see what you're saying, and I think the difference in our opinions is going to come from the fact that I don't really seem to find it quite as scary as you do. I will say that it's very, I can see why you feel different. Like, it's definitely a lot closer. I think with the first RE, it does rely on jump scares sometimes, but also sometimes it's like an enemy you know is there, just kind of crawling out of nowhere. And it's that tension and that stress and that fucking, like, worry, you know? Yeah. Yeah, this game is pretty impressively good looking. Like, yeah. I need the fuse first, law. I believe. As a classic phrase goes, now I've got a machine gun. Ha ha ha. It's not that big a deal, to be 100% honest. Okay. It's just... Part of my nature is just to obsessively save. Okay, first of all, I should explain a couple of things. One, this is pretty far into the game. Like, I'm pretty sure I'm getting close to the end of the game. So, if you don't want to be spoiled, you're probably going to want to get out now. We haven't seen any story content yet. Oh, yeah, how he got his hand cut off. I'm willing to tolerate this, and some people really seem like they're unable to. But basically what happened... his hand gets cut off, and then it gets stapled and medicined back on. If you notice, during the game, the main character, Ethan, can lose his foot and reattach it using the medicine. So I figured it was the exact same thing. The only difference was she used staples. Okay, so I'm gonna go on a limb and say that the reason the law was telling me to. Let's just move. Okay. Yeah. Jeez Louise. Okay. Yeah, for the hand requiring staples thing, I think it might just be a gamey way to make his hand look creepier. As opposed to actually being rooted in any sort of reality. Well, okay, I say rooted in reality. As opposed to actually being rooted in, like, like, actual logic. I think it's just a game thing to make it more dramatic and explain why you have the hand, and to make the losing the foot thing more shocking. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I can see why you'd think it's weird. I actually kind of agree. I'm not 100% sure on the logic of that. But, I don't know. Okay, so now the problem we're presented with, I suppose, is that... Okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah, I figured I need to place both. I just realized that to get at the, to get to that fuse, I need to go down there, but I don't know how to get back up. Oh, right. Sorry. What? Oh my god. Bullshit. Okay, that's the one problem I have with this section as well. I have no way of checking my health. The game's just kind of fucking terrible at telling me that, so whatever. I mean, I guess there's blood smears, so I should've known. Yeah, I didn't have any health, I guess. Okay. There. Yeah, no, she doesn't have a codex. Oh. So I guess you're dead. Alright, fine, whatever. Yeah. No, I understand. It's fine. Like, it's easy to forget because it's such a constant part of the earlier game. But basically, for most of the game, you have a little watch that tells you your health. Except for this section, which... Alright, you know what? On the one hand, I think they should have given you an actual way of being able to tell what it is. on the other hand, it's like I kind of respect not just shoehorning in a reason, but it's kind of annoying. But yeah. Yeah, so basically, to explain a little bit better why I wasn't figuring that part out, jumping has only really been a mechanic for this portion of the game, so... No. I really don't think the blood splatter system works very well. I think it really gets in the way of you being able to visually tell, see things. And I personally think it's more of a pain than anything else. Alright. Yeah, I literally haven't stored anything. That's fine. Okay. Okay, let's see. I just want to make sure. What's that? Oh yeah, the lock. I don't have a lock pick though, so. Yeah, I still think I disagree with you on that.
Waiting.
One. Yep. Revelations? Yeah, I think there are some visual similarities between this game and Revelations. I can definitely see that. Bench rare me for a boss fight. Just with who? Please tell me I don't have to. Okay. I know it's coming. I think. Okay. Thank you. an antique coin. I definitely need that.
Ethan? Hey, shh, I know. I'm not gonna hurt you. Hell, I never would have if I could have helped it.
What do you mean? What the fuck?
I'm no killer, son. Neither is Marguerite, nor my boy Lucas, or even Zoe here. That girl, Evelyn, she did this.
What the hell is she? Now, what did she do to you?
She infected us with her gift. That's what she calls it. I found her near a busted out tanker in the bayou. Everything changed after that.
So she infects you and then she takes control?
No. Not exactly, son. She forces her way into your mind. Your soul. You can't fight back. You are connected to her, and you can't resist the urge to. Oh, you're a different person after that.
Just like Mia. So Mia sent me that message because of Evelyn.
Listen, the girl just wants a family of her own. She's the key, all right? You find her, and you stop her. Ethan, free my family. Please.
Jeez.
Evelyn, stay away from him.
Why? He doesn't love you. I can make him love you.
Don't hurt him.
Silly, I told you I'm not gonna hurt him.
Don't you dare.
So what? You're not my mommy. Remember?
Mia, how?
There's no time. You have to get out of here and find her. Here, take this.
What? Wait, what are you doing? What are you doing?
Saving your life. You need to go. I won't be able to resist for much longer.
No.
Now go kill that little bitch.
No. No.
Mia! No!
Oh dear. Oh shit.
Okay, you little bitch. Where the fuck are you?
It sure is. Huh. Huh. Well, that's interesting. Indeed, the plot doth thicken. I've taken me as things. Okay. So let's see what we got. Oh, baby. We got all our gear back. Okay. Did you now? Did you? Let's see. All right, so the plot indeed thickens. Nine coins. To get the magnum, I need the nine coins.
Alpha One, this is Bravo One. Do you read?
This is Alpha One. Report. Did you find anything?
A thorough search of the Baker property revealed zero survivors. Repeat, zero survivors. We did find evidence of a skirmish.
Evelyn?
Negative. However, we did find several encrypted messages from the Baker's son, Lucas, to an unknown third party. You can probably guess who that was.
That's just great. We've had reports using the abandoned mine south of the property. I'm gonna go have a look.
Roger that. We'll meet you at those coordinates.
If you encounter Evelyn, orders are shoot to kill. Repeat. Shoot to kill.
Okay. All right. See, I'm not really sure what to do. Hey, you know what? Screw it. I don't know if there's enough coins for me to grab, to be honest. I don't know if there's another coin hiding somewhere out there. Okay. All the things I've gotten in this. Does it say loser on Ethan's arm? No, it shouldn't. Because. It should not say loser on Ethan's arm. Otherwise. Actually, yeah, no, it shouldn't. Otherwise, that would mean I would lose. I would have lost the challenge. Like, that literally means that you've lost. Sounds horrible. Ooh, okay. Oh, goody. I get to deal with the jigsaw. Impersonator again. Yeah, the DLC. Also, I like how, Pa Baker says, none of us are killers. Which kind of indicates he still doesn't know that his son literally murdered a small child. Interesting wrinkle, but whatever. Doesn't make me sad. It's kind of sad to see these people turn into deranged monsters. Oh, good. Thank you. Okay. Damn it. Yeah, sounds like it. Also, you know, I really should have figured that there was more going on considering they actually knew the dude's name and mentioned him and where his location. What did he do? Who knows? Things are going well so far. All right. Oh my gosh. I'm at like fucking full health and they're doing that. Well, okay, up until this point, I really haven't been relying on the, pistol in that area. Okay. Thank you. Yes, I am. Well, I didn't get the Magnum, but that is the strongest handgun. After the upgrade and the enemies get more health, it's still kind of a piece of shit. It's also using enhanced ammo. I'm using the broken handgun, yeah. Jeez, Louise, fucking asshole. You let your family get turned into zombies. She's getting sick and getting gray hairs. Oh my gosh. Yeah, I noticed basically what happens She's getting gray hairs and her skin's getting wrinkly. Also. Okay. Okay, so basically, fuck you, Resident Evil. When the bacterium that grows inside of the E-series infects a human, hereafter referred to as mold. Mold is fungus, you stupid assholes. Alright, Lal, what am I supposed to be seeing here? Alright, see you later, Rad. Evie's looking sick or something. Her skin is getting all wrinkly and she's getting gray hairs. Yes, please, tell me. Tell me, Lal, because you keep stringing me out. Thanks, I appreciate it. Wait a second. Okay. Her skin is getting all wrinkly and she's getting gray hairs. Is that supposed to happen? It's almost like she's getting old all of a sudden. Wait. It's almost like she's getting old. Oh my fucking gosh. Holy shit. Oh my gosh. Fuck, fuck, fuck. Fuck, fuck, fuck. I figured it out. Fuck. Oh my gosh. Holy shit. That old woman in the wheelchair. That's been her the entire time, isn't it? Oh my gosh, it's the fucking old woman who's always in the wheelchair. Of course, the fucking hallucinations are just that, hallucinations. I should have known they were going to do something with her. Yeah, jeez, I didn't even stop to think about that, but you're right. You and my seat. Holy shit. As a microbiology major, this is tickling all my buttons. Look at that. The auto-inducer pheromones used for quorum sensing in Pseudomonas bacteria. Yeah. Fucking Lucas. Asshole. Willing to sell out his entire family for fucking money. What a dick. But yeah, no. Quorum sensing. I love that. Also, they mentioned Pseudomonas. So this game is a 10 out of 10. Yeah, he doesn't really seem to, he always struck me as a socio-fucking-path. And I sincerely hope I get to fucking blow him up with flame rounds. Fucking prick. Salt mine, so soon I should find Torchman around here. Huh. It's a funny joke, and it's also one that he'll never see, because of course he fucking won't. Okay. Yeah, it's a short jab. He knows we love him, though. I'm sure people who watch this stream later will have no idea what the fuck that is, but considering that only, like, one or two people are probably ever going to watch this stream, I don't care. Oh. Okay, fine, let's go get the bobblehead. I might as well. I've already missed probably most of them. Where's Bobblehead? Where is the Bobblehead? The upper scaffold outside. Yeah, what about it? Oh, okay. Yeah, I hear it. Got it. I like to imagine that basically if you stab the wrong thing with the necrotoxin, you get the bad ending. I can almost guarantee that's what's gonna be the deal. It's like gonna be like, oh, stab the little girl, and it's gonna be like, it's not actually, it's not her. Okay, if I'm in for the hardest fight in the game, then I might as well get the proper equipment, really. Okay, let's see. First of all. Oh, no. Alright, Law, make up your mind. Should I bring this grenade launcher? Okay, fine. Alright, just tell me now, should I save the grenade launcher for later, or should I use it now? Actually, you know what? Yeah, okay. Let's see. Let's see. Okay, if that's the case. No. Yeah, I figured not. You know what? I'll save the grenade launcher. I mean, it's not like the shotgun has much ammo, but you know, whatever. Okay. We'll just use a shit ton of these things. Yeah, we're getting to the end. This is pretty exciting. Okay. I'm not looking forward to this.
Die.
Fuck!
Thanks for my bombs. Yeah, that was pretty tense. Bad news, I'm infected since I'm seeing hallucinations, I presume. Uh-oh. No, I do not get another item box, apparently. It should be alright. I got shit tons of machine gun ammo, so I should be okay.
I'm sure of it. It's not here. It's gone. It's gone!
Didn't mean to hurt me.
Kill him, Mommy.
Oh, but you shouldn't have done that! It fucking hurts!
He doesn't want to be my daddy? Then he can die.
All right.
Now it's Mommy's turn to kill you.
You're gonna be one of us. And then maybe you'll play nicely.
I'm not playing.
No! Get that away from me!
I don't need your pity. Leave me!
You.
Why does everyone hate me?
Oh boy. Shit's getting intense.
I'm a big pal dad.
Holy shoot.
You're just a little boy.
Use it!
time, Joey.
Yeah, they're gonna blow my brains out and leave me for dead, aren't they? Yep, they're gonna kill me.
I'm Redfield. I'm glad we found you.
The fuck took you guys so long?
What the fuck? What the fuck? What?
Ethan?
Mia. You made it. I'm glad.
Did I?
What the fuck is this shit? Oh, goodness me. Did that helicopter have an umbrella?
They say that when one door closes, another opens. Well, a door closed tonight. And what a long night it was. But not just for me. Me and I weren't the only victims here. So were the Bakers. It was that thing, Evelyn, who made them that way.
What's the
but
fuck?
But now Evelyn's dead.
What the fuck?
And these guys are what? Here to clean up the mess.
What the fuck?
I had just come to terms with losing Mia.
What the fuck?
And now she's back and wants to start over. Put all this behind us. Maybe this is where the next door opens.
What the fuck? Umbrella? Why the fuck would you name your... Okay, I feel like I'm missing some story context here. That's gonna be sold as DLC. Oh my gosh. Unless this is some sort of alternate reality. I don't know.
Go tell Aunt Rhodey.
What the fuck?
Go. Tell Aunt Rhodey. Go tell Aunt Rhodey that everybody's dead. I was raised in a deep, dark hole. A prisoner with no parole. They locked me up and took my soul.
I don't understand.
Call to him when he will come. She'll run to him like he's the one. His arms that stretch, but when she's done, he'll be torn apart.
sure I will. I'm gonna withhold on saying much more until I know what happened at the end of the film. I'm so confused in a couple of ways. Still, I'm not going to say the ending was bad, per se. I mean, I guess you could argue it has problems, but, you know, whatever. If you look at the credits... Yeah, okay, I guess. It's not some other Redfield, yeah. Well, I mean, I guess, is it like a clone or something made by the Internet Corporation? I don't know. I don't know. David Cockman. I will laugh at that because I'm a small child. Haha. Yeah, he does look really different. It could just kind of be a reboot, I guess. My theory is it's the Chris we know, and it's not the Umbrella we're expecting. Yeah, I figured... Okay, here's the thing. It's like, I read the news... There's a newspaper article in here that says 16 years since, the fucking Raccoon City disaster. So I guess it's possible they named a bioterrorism organization, anti-bioterrorism organization, after Umbrella to kind of be symbolic... But A, why the hell was Ethan expecting them? That kind of confused me. And B, I don't know. I don't know. I'm just going to wait until the end of this fucking thingamajig. Yeah, it's possible it could have just been a statement of relief, thinking that... Well, no, but the thing is that, like, the way he acted, like, he totally expected it. True, true. That is actually a point. Yeah, okay, here's the thing. I think at the end of the day, it's like, in horror games, I think horror, I think it's best if you leave some stuff unexplained. But at the same time, I feel like there's just a little too much up in the air here, and I completely think you're right. I think they're gonna sell pieces of DLC that elaborate on and explain shit. And they're totally gonna charge for it. We couldn't get a really well-made Capcom game without the bullshit now, could we? Yeah. Yeah. Well, that certainly was an ending. Yeah. No, yeah. Exactly. And it's like, I think it's a shame. Because this is a very good game. Like, I mean, to each their own, but this is a very well made, very well done game. And even during the boat section, which I was a little iffier on, it's good. It maintains the quality, the atmosphere, the tone. It's a really well made game. I really liked it. And it disappoints me that I think parts of it are gonna get, like, dealt with in a fucking DLC that you have to pay for. Because, of course, why not? Like, okay, things that they didn't explain. Did Ethan know? What's the deal with the new umbrella? And what the fuck happened to Lucas? I really expected that we were gonna deal with him. Especially because he was a fucking dick heel, and I wanted to make sure that he fucking was under the ground. Yeah, and that's the rub, isn't it? You know? It's like, you can argue about the DLC, but ultimately, the game, I think, is still complete. It doesn't feel like people hacked off parts of the game. It feels like it needs a little bit more stuff, but overall, it's pretty complete and a full package. I got my money's worth. And you know what? It's like, it's easy to say, oh, fuck you, Capcom. But if they're gonna give us a game this well made, this well delivered, and this well put together, and then ask us for DLC. Oh, there's Pebble. Oh, they went out of business and it makes me so fucking sad. You know, I don't even know if I'd say they hacked off parts of the story. I'd say there's parts of the story, near the end especially, that they left really ambiguous to intentionally slot DLC into, but it doesn't feel like they chopped parts off. He already knows. He's the one who brought it up, and yada yada yada. I already talked to him about that. Oh my gosh, how fucking long can these credits go on? I've seen worse credits. I'm sure you can watch this video and pause it. Okay, let's see what we got. 8 hours and 48 minutes. Let's see. Oh, I almost found all the files. Item box opened. Item box is opened. Oh yeah, deaths. Actually, where are the deaths? Oh, 14? Alright, whatever. Additional free content. Not a hero. Oh, gosh. Oh, no. Capcom, you just made a great horror game, and it already looks like you're going to start shitting all over it. Oh, fuck you, Capcom. Oh. Oh, my God. They couldn't even resist fucking advertising the DLC at the end of the game, the fucks. It's free, but fuck you. Alright, I'm gonna end the stream now, and we'll talk more about this in Discord, but thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. Whoever else is in here, I appreciate it too. You've been very quiet. But yeah, thanks for watching. I appreciate everyone walking through this game with me. It's been a fucking great time. It really has. Bye.